All right, we're treading water to start for 2 minutes. Basically, your arms or legs are moving. Don't let anything touch the floor. This is the warm-up. We'll start with 2 minutes. All right, so after you tread water for 2 minutes, we'll tell you what to do. All right, so next exercise is swimming for minutes. You'll swim for 8 minutes. You don't have to. Smooth and relaxed. Breathing when you need to. Okay, they're just finishing up their 8 minute swim. Immediately go into the walk, push, pull. Okay, so this is the walk, push, pull. It's 30 seconds long. Okay, in case it didn't hear that, it's 30 seconds long. Walk, push, pull. Once you get to the edge, turn around,
going the other way. Another example of push, pull. Okay, these are double tap skips. 1, 2, 3, pause. 1, 2, 3, pause. 1, 2, 3. Be explosive, be as fast and as aggressive as you can with those.
Yeah, yeah.
Times 5 on each leg.
In the water though?
Yeah. Yeah, stay in the water with it.
Yep. Small, tiny kicks. Alright. This is what we're gonna call kickboarding without a kickboard. Holding on to the wall.
You want them fast if you want them in control. Now don't get out of control.
In fact, I have the camera below the water.
I said, do these fast, but stay in control the whole time. You don't want to pull anything here, but stay smooth.
Split jumps in the water.
I'm going to go underneath to let you see these.
6 total jumps. Mimicking running arms above the water. Kickboard, 30 more seconds.
Again, in control. Blood flow. Feet stay under the water. In control.
30 seconds. Tuck jumps are next. 5 total. Knees come to chest. Let's go. There you go. Go for it.
Cool. Last exercise, 2 minute swim. You can treat this as a cool down, but again, the goal is to keep the blood flowing. This circuit should take about 15 minutes when you do it simultaneously. I realize some of us are better swimmers than others, and there's nothing wrong with that.